Hari Om. Welcome to Vedānta Jñana Yajña, 42nd week. Let us begin with a prayer to our Pujya Gurudev. Samast jana kalyani niratam karunamayam namami chinmayam devam sadgurum brahma vidvaram om shanti shanti shanti. Until the last session we have spoken so clearly about the one single goal of Vedanta. What the Vedas point out to is the goal of humanity. We are human beings. We are different than all the other creations. Someone said, we are different because we are able to say that we are different. No, we are different because we do not take things just as they are. Like the animal smells, tastes, and if it feels palatable, they take it or they leave it. They do not think that why is it palatable? Why is it not palatable? It is only the human intellect which prompts him to ask this question. Why? How? What? All these are intellectual questions which a human being alone, in the mind of the human being alone, it comes. Therefore, to reach to the goal, the highest goal, the goal of reaching your own self. When it is the question of reaching the highest goal, can you think that there will not be a very specific path or paths? For smallest of the things, for example, preparing a cup of chai. Chai is the Indian tea. To prepare a cup of chai, we have authors who have written different books. We have procedures. We have systems in place how the thing has to be done. For such a simple thing, including the manuals which are written for space travel. We have not yet started, but we are going to start that very shortly. Then how can anybody imagine that the journey that we are as human beings about to embark could be without instructions, without a proper charted path? Thinking that way will be very naive. Therefore, today onwards, we are going to take all the sessions in the direction of self-knowledge, knowing your own self, but with proper instructions from the Vedas, from the great masters. Vedas say, Shraddhavan labhate jnanam, meaning Shraddhavan, man, person with faith. Only a person with faith reaches the knowledge. Or, in other words, knowledge dawns into that person who has faith. Faith is a word which we have discussed before. Here we do not mean faith means blind faith. Blind faith is not what we are discussing. We are talking about that faith which a child, a baby, in its infancy, it cries out when the tummy rumbles inside. The child does not know who is going to feed. But the child knows this for sure in his heart, that when the cry reaches to my mother, wherever she is, she would be, however busy she is, she would come running and feed the child. In the same way, Shraddha, that confidence in you, that yes, it is, that faith, when you start going to the school as a small child again, and when the teacher shows, look at this, a fruit, this is called an apple, A for apple. We don't stand over there and say, prove it, that this is apple, that this is not orange. We don't. We look at that fruit and we look at that teacher. We look at that explanation. We understand. We listen. And we have this confidence. Yes, the teacher is saying the right thing. This is A for apple. That time we don't say, but the pronunciation of A is A. Then writing of apple starts with A. So why is it apple and not apple? This we do later, don't we? Faith has to be understood, that feeling of doing anything for your loved one. Don't we do this? As Pujya Gurudev so brilliantly have said, that you could give without loving somebody, but you can never love somebody without giving. Isn't it? That love that we talk about. You have to give love, then you receive love. You have to do things unconditioned, unconditional. That is love. Therefore, when there is love, you can do something or everything for that person. Similarly, love to a human being or to somebody who is lower than human being can be expressed. But when we speak about love to Bhagwan, love to Gurus, that word love changes into Shraddha, faith, devotion. And that has to be, which doesn't shake, it doesn't move, it has to be atal, it has to be established. So brilliantly Guruji has once said, bhakti wo hai jo bhakti nahi hai. In English, it means that is faith which does not shake. It is not faithless, it is faithful. Shastras have explained that there are five kind of Shraddha. There is a beautiful prasanga, a small episode in the Ramayana itself, where Bhagwan Shri Ram himself is giving this knowledge to his own younger brother, Shri Lakshmana. This portion of Ramayana is called Ramagita. I am quoting these five Shraddhas from there. First Shraddha, the first kind of Shraddha that one should have is that Brahman is, that the consciousness is. Without having this faith, how can you reach your goal? The goal is reaching or achieving or realizing Brahman in your own self. Therefore, you must have this faith, unshaken faith, that though I can't see it now, though I can't understand it, still it is, and a day will come when I will find it, I will see it. This has to be the first Shraddha. Don't we? Also, when we start in some research, we don't know what is going to be there. But we have a goal in mind to reach. So long as your goal is clear in your mind, you will keep going in your research. If your mind gets clouded, if your mind gets wavering, then you can never reach the goal. Therefore, the first kind of Shraddha, faith you should have, is in your goal. Brahman is. The second faith, Shraddha, that you should have is by Pramanya, that authority which tells us that Brahman is. What is that? That is Vedas. Having unconditional faith in Vedas, that what Vedas are saying, they are the authority on Brahma Vidya. Brahma Vidya, the knowledge of the self. You have got to have the faith. For example, we have all heard this. Many of us have studied this. It says, E is equal to mc square. What? E is equal to mc square. Those who have studied this or read this, they will immediately understand what it means. It has been said and it has been proven. But do you understand? Do I understand? These are small statements. In the same way, Vedas are statements. Aham Brahmasmi, Tattvamasi. Only those who have actually seen that, they can explain it to us. And this is where comes the third Shraddha. The Shraddha in your Guru, in your Master, who has experienced this. Today you may not understand it. Today you may only have an intellectual understanding about what is E is equal to mc square. But when you go into work and research, and when you use those mantras, you will realize it yourself. In the same way, having this firm conviction that what my Guru is saying, Tattvamasi, that thou art, I should have 100% faith in that. Why? Because the Guru is not saying anything out of his hat. He is once again saying what Vedanta is saying, what Vedas are saying, in a language, in the way that the student can understand. It is customization to your need. A guru is always customized according to the shishya, according to the student. Therefore, the Vedas themselves have said, Shrutim patha gurun mukha. That study the Shruti, Shruti meaning Veda. Study the Vedas under the tutelage of a Siddha Guru, a realized master. That was third kind of faith. The fourth kind of faith, faith in your own ability, self-confidence. You should have the unfailing confidence in yourself that the path you are walking on, you will reach the goal. You will see it through. Not like a weak-hearted person that they start with a journey and at the first sign of a difficulty, they say, no. This is too difficult. It's not my cup of tea. And they move away. They will never reach anywhere. Not even like those who move ahead to a point where they feel, I have achieved everything in their own mind. With their own ego. I have realized everything. They shall also not reach anything. You shall reach there only when it is there inside you, completely clear. This faith has to be there that I will reach that ultimate goal. The highest goal that we have set for ourselves. Finally, but not the least, your dharma. My dharma, faith in my dharma. What is my dharma? Your guru may have prescribed you some spiritual sadhanas, spiritual actions, spiritual karmas, that do this, and follow the path and you shall reach. There are many who go to a guru and ask, hey guru, please tell me the path to the self-realization. And there are many. For example, the guru may ask to a student, take a japamala, beads of 108, and sit quietly in a clean and pious place early in the morning and do japa of Gayatri. And the student, with all his force, he starts doing that. 1 day, 2 days, 10 days, 1 month, 2 months, till the time somebody else meets him and he says, "Ah, I saw you doing some mantra. What mantra are you doing?" "Oh, I am doing Gayatri. My guru told me to do Gayatri." "Ah," the friend says, "oh, Gayatri. Well, Gayatri is very good. But what to tell you about Mahamrityunjay Mantra? You know you should do Mahamrityunjay Mantra and you shall be here and you shall be there." And the student's mind changes, and he starts following something else. So for a time, he goes in this direction, as the guru said. Then he turns the direction. Then, if you do not follow your dharma, your path which the guru has shown until the end, how can you expect to reach there in time and perfectly? It is impossible. Therefore, Vedanta has given us, guru has explained to us, what are the paths to reach there. Shall I jog your memory? Go back, think. Those sessions where we spoke about sadhana chatushtaya sampanna adhikari, the student who is endowed with the great four virtues and values. Very quickly, let me jog your memory. The values are viveka, vairagya, the shadasampatti, and mumukshutvam. Now someone would say, "Oh, but I don't know any of these." Therefore, I'll request not only those who are seeing this video for the first time, but even those who have been following our videos, our Vedanta Jnana Yajna from the beginning, to kindly go back to the videos and revisit these sessions which we had elaborately discussed. What is Viveka? What is Vairagya? And then once again, listen to this talk and it will make a lot more sense. May I please get your attention once again? When we speak about faith, it is not just an intellectual exercise. You cannot intellectually love your mother. You have to love your mother by your heart. To love means to devote. Devote means faith. Faith means bhakti. And that has to come from within. And if your goal is reaching the highest, and if you are not able to love the representation of the highest, how can you imagine to reach there? Therefore, developing Shraddha, developing bhakti, love for God, is the most important aspect for an aspirant of self-knowledge. This is but a means, not the goal. However, without the means, can we reach the goal ever? Nah, never. Therefore, starting with Shraddha. With these few words today, let me take a Madhyavirama. And in the next sessions, we will slowly move ahead into the direction of self-knowledge. Kindly join me in thanking Bhagwan, in thanking Gurudev, in thanking our parents and all those great souls who were instrumental in our lives, knowing or unknowingly, who have guided us till this day. Let us remember all of them and thank them. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate. Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om.
Hari Om to one and all.